And then based on the suitability of that parameter, we can decide, okay, that water is suitable for the plankton growth or not. But why will be looking at plankton growth when we are working inside like fish, right? हम फिश में हम काम कर रहे थे व्हाई वी आर कंसर्न अबाउट द प्लैंकटन बिकॉज प्लैंकटन इज द फूड फॉर फिश व्हेन द प्लैंकटन कैन ग्रो इन अ वाटर बॉडी देन दैट वाटर इज गुड फॉर फिश टू ग्रो राइट तो वाटर क्वालिटी पैरामीटर के हिसाब से देयर आर लाइक सम फिजिकल पैरामीटर्स सम आर केमिकल पैरामीटर्स राइट नाउ वी आर डूइंग सो वन ऑफ द पीएचडी स्टूडेंट्स इज डूइंग वाटर क्वालिटी पैरामीटर So starting from so some of the parameter we can look into the field itself. We have the probe. We can check like 7-8 parameters in the field itself. pH हुआ, dissolved oxygen हुआ. अगर हमारे probe अच्छा है, तो dissolved oxygen also we can check in the field. Hardness हम check कर सकते हैं. Hardness तो हम alkalinity check कर सकते हैं. ये सब चीज हम लोग field में check कर सकते हैं. And some other chemical parameters we need to bring the samples. To a laboratory and then we have to go for checking what is called those hardness and other parameters like nutrients hai ki nahi jaise there are several nutrients right micronutrients bahut sare minerals vagera hum check karte hain and with organization under that organization there are like many institutes under different disciplines like dairy also comes under ICAR veterinary animal science also comes under ICAR Fishery science also comes under ICAR. Agriculture, horticulture comes under ICAR. So fisheries, there are like several fisheries institute in ICAR, and under the several fisheries institute, there was a project called nutrient profiling of fish. Because nowadays people are thinking of people are concerned about what they are eating. Nowadays people are health conscious, right? We go for walking, and I'm not going for walking. I don't look like I go for walking and exercise. But people nowadays, like who live in like a, some civilized world, and still in our country too, people go for walking and eating good food. क्या बोलते हैं उसको health friendly food हम लोग खाते हैं. Then fish is a good source of that health friendly food. Starting from the protein, it has a well balanced amino acids, and then the fish has a very good oil. Compared to other animals, like when we cut open other animal, we can see a fat deposition. When we cut open the fish, you can rarely see the fat deposition there. Fish has a very good kind of oil, which we call omega-3 fatty acids and all, right? Fatty acids are constituents of the fat. Fat is a different thing and fatty acids are different thing. There is a glycerol backbone and when you add the fatty acid in the glycerol backbone, it will become lipid or fat, right? So we look for those amino acid profile, protein profile, fatty acid profile, enzyme profile and all in fish and then we tell and recommend the people how much we need to eat. There is a recommendation how much protein we need to take is 1 gram per kg body weight. If I am like 60 kg, if my weight is 60 kg, I need to take 60 gram of protein every day. So to take the 60 gram of protein every day, how many fish we need to eat, right? And then for that, I need to know how much protein is there in 100 gram of fish. So generally in fish, what happens like 15 to 20 grams, like 15 to 18 grams per 100 gram protein is available. And to what is called satiate our requirement, how much we need to take, how many fish we need to take. If the fish has like a 20 gram of protein in 100 gram, we need to take how much? 300 gram, right? Total it will be 60 gram protein. 300 gram fish if we take, the fish will give you 60 gram of protein. That kind of a recommendation we should give because in India, in world like FAO, WHO, they have recommended how much protein we need to take, how much lipid and everything we need to take, every day to make our, nutrient balance and all. So in India, ICMR has recommended the nutrient requirements and how much we need to take. We need to advise to the consumers. So different fish has different nutrient composition. And then we need to look for the nutrient composition of every fish and then the consumer should know like how much I need to take to satiate my requirement. So this was the nutrient profiling project which was running until last year. And then she's a student, new student under Dr. Devajit Sharma and we are working in this team together. So he's an acting director right now and we are working the team together. I'm also handling this student here. And she's recently joined PhD student. She's working on the nutrient profiling project itself. So we are in her project, we will be looking at seasonal change in nutrient profile of cited wets, which are so many. So yeah, because in fish, what happens? No, with the change in season, they have like gonadal rhythmicity, gonadal development, breeding, and all the natural environment. And for preparation of gonad for breeding and all, the nutrient has to partition for the gonadal development, right? And then also depend on the temperature change and all the nutrient profile and everything will be changing. So we'll be looking at the change in nutrient profile around the year in different seasons. And basically we'll be taking 5 seasons in a year and looking at how those nutrients are changing in 5 years. And my project is basically digestive physiology and reproductive physiology project. And then I'll be looking at the markers of the appetite markers. So we'll be looking at the smaller fish. When we go for a bigger fish, we can take out the gut and then tell when the food is there, not in the gut, then we can tell, okay, I fed the fish in the morning, right? 10 o'clock I fed the fish, and after 2 hours I'll be checking the gut, and if the food is not there in the gut, okay, the fish is hungry because there is no food in the stomach, right? For the smaller baby fishes, we don't know whether gut is very small, right? It's very difficult to cut open and see. So what we decided, okay, they won't come and ask for the food also, because they'll be learning how to take the food, and they're like, they are not that habituated compared to the other higher, aged animals. Yeah, that's why we thought of how to determine whether the fish is feeling hungry or not. And then I'm looking at that project called Return of Appetite. So basically I'm using that histology based marker. And then he's a PhD student from CIFE, Central Institute of, master student from Central. His master dissertation project is based on that. So we'll be looking at thick label, histology based label. So in histology, we'll be looking at, so when I feed the fish in the morning and over the period of time, 1 hour, 2 hour, 4 hour, 6 hour, 8 hour, 10, 12 hours, over the period of time, how histological features in the digestive tracts are changing, and then how the enzyme activity profile is changing, and then how other appetite.
Yeah. What enzyme?
Yeah, enzyme will be doing. We are taking 4 digestive enzymes in this work, and then we are also looking at what is called appetite peptides. Some are anorexigenic peptides which inhibit the food intake. And some are orexigenic peptides, right? There are 20-40 peptides already reported in fish. And then, expression pattern of those peptides, the gene expression of those peptides. If prior to the eating, if the peptides are highly expressed, then we can tell, okay, they are orexigenic peptides, and this indicates the fish is feeling hungry, and this is directly correlated with some of the histological features the emergence of more number of goblet cells in the tract and all. We can validate, okay, these histology markers is well validated appetite markers based on the molecular already established markers. So that kind of work we are doing on that. So these are the summary of what we are doing. If you want to see the histology work, you can come and see.
Yes, yeah, sir.
So these are the
मैम, कौन सी फिश है
ना? बहुत प्यारा लग रहा है ना।
ये मेनली आपको इंडिया में कश्मीर में या हिमाचल में मिलता है
सर। ये कौन सी फिश है?
ये है रेनबो ट्राउट।